Well, as you know, we are in the middle of spring break, as it were, for the students right across Ontario, including right here in Halton. And unfortunately, as we know, the government has announced that in-person learning has been suspended till further notice. So after this break, most kids aren't going back to school. But as I said, most kids aren't going back to school. That doesn't mean all of them aren't going back to school. And here to talk more about that is the president of the Elementary Teachers Federation of Ontario Halton Branch, Kathy Proctor. Thank you so much for joining me today.
My pleasure.
So let's talk about that. I had mentioned most students, but not all students are exempt from going back to in-person learning. Can we talk about who, in fact, is going to be going back next week?
So generally, it's the students with special education needs, high special education needs, for whom online learning is not really a very viable alternative. These are children in life skills classes, self-contained classes, communication classes. Those kids will be back in school on Tuesday.
So there was some mention of that in the announcement earlier by the province, but they didn't really elaborate. And I think that caused quite some concern for you and also for our teachers that have spoken with you. Can you talk about that a little bit?
The problem with the ministry announcement was that it was not very specific about who should be coming back and who shouldn't. So it's left up to each and every board to decide what students will be returning and which students will not be returning. And that leaves a lot of room for interpretation of whose needs can't and can be met online.
So then let's talk about next week then. I mean, you talked about who's going, so how do we prepare for this? There's obviously concerns with the rising cases. That is the reason why schools have been, in-person learning has been suspended. But the concerns, they don't stop there. There is still a risk for those teachers and students going in.
Absolutely. The students who are returning, many of them, as well as having educational needs, have very complex medical needs as well. And so many of them are at increased risk. They have poor immune systems, they have underlying conditions that make them medically fragile. And so when they return to school, they're with the other students in the classroom and the adults in the classroom who have not yet been vaccinated. And so that really puts both students and staff at greater risk.
So, what is it that then that you're looking for, that the teachers are looking for to do? I mean, these are kids that don't benefit from at-home learning. They need to be in school. So, what is it that you're looking for from the government?
So we're looking for the educators working in those classrooms to be vaccinated immediately, today. Call them up, phone the boards and say who's going back on Monday, and getting those teachers, those educators vaccinated now. Even at that, it still takes, we know, 2 weeks to acquire any kind of immunity from a first shot. But when teachers are protected, students are protected as well. So we want those teachers vaccinated and not to have to wait until the province, finally gets around to vaccinating all teachers.
Now, the government did announce that some of them will be able to go as of book an appointment as of this week, but that does not include our teachers in Halton, right?
Well, what we've heard from public health is that the system will be open for teachers on April 16th, on Friday, but there's still going to be a waiting list. I represent nearly 3,000 members, and with all the Catholic schools, and it's a lot of people who will be waiting for vaccines. And those teachers who will be working from home, obviously we want all teachers vaccinated and done right away, but I am especially concerned for those teachers that need to go back into schools on Monday, that they need to be vaccinated now. Like, they don't need to wait till Friday to be able to access the booking system. And then, you know, maybe it'll be 10 days or 2 weeks before they can actually get their vaccination, and another 2 weeks before the immunity is sufficient. So it could still be a month from now that those teachers will be working face to face, and literally it's face to face. There's no kind of physical distancing or social distancing in these classrooms with these children with special needs. So these teachers need to be vaccinated immediately.
We have maybe just a few seconds left. I just wanted to ask, are they scared? Are these teachers scared?
Absolutely, they're scared. They're scared for themselves, and they're scared for their students, because they know that as long as they're not vaccinated, they're capable of transmitting COVID to their students. And as I said, many of these students are very medically fragile and would be at great risk from acquiring COVID-19.
Okay, well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me. I think this was a really important conversation to have for our viewers to clarify. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your time.